I'm going to talk about tattoos. We all either know somebody with a tattoo or have tattoos, but there's different importance to tattoos. There's different meanings, there's different languages, there's different symbols, and tattoos didn't just start this century or in the 70s or 80s. They started prehistoric, and then there's the ancient world, and then it came to modern times. And the modern times is affected by the ancient world, and the ancient world is affected by the prehistoric. Michelle DeLeo gave this awesome quote to kind of relate the importance of tattoos and like the language of them. She said, "Tattoos have a power and magic all their own. They decorate the body, but they also enhance the soul," which I thought was kind of cool. So one of the first prehistoric tattoos was the Tamian Basin mummy, and he has decorative patterns which were symbolic and protective in a way. This is his hand, but he has like moons on his eyelids and just like different natural things. So that was pretty cool. And then there's the Iron Age mummy who has animals, and those were to ward off bad spirits. So there was a tiger, a panther, an eagle, and like a goat combined, which meant, they all meant something different. And then the most famous was Ozaidi, who was found in 1991. He's supposed to be 5,300 years old now, they would say, or around there. He has a total of 57 tattoos, but his tattoos were different because they were therapeutic. We have acupuncture now to relieve pain, or you can get steroid injections, I know. Well, his are the form of that, but back in the day. So he has tattoos wherever there's joints, knees, spine, and those are all to relieve pain of some sort. And then there's the ancient world. And the Japanese used clay figures, and like I have a tattoo in memory of my mom. Well, their tattoos were clay figures, and they would like put different meanings and symbols. So if they were a mother, they'd have a symbol. If they were like a hierarchy or someone who was in power, they'd have a symbol on it. So it's kind of just like another way of tattooing, but not on their own body. The Chinese, however, believe that, same to a lot of the Christians do, if you tattoo your body, you're contaminating your body, you're violating all these rules that your body is like a temple, you don't destroy it, you don't harm it. But if you were a slave or a criminal, then they would kind of brand you with a tattoo so that they'd be like, this is a person you want to stay away from because they did a criminal act. Which is kind of wrong in a way, but it's the times, so you can't really go against it. And then the Egyptians, in the ancient world, marked women with tattoos. This is Bayes, who is a god. He was a dwarf, and he would be found on women's thighs, and he protected women during pregnancy. So he would protect the womb, the baby, during the process and even afterwards. But they were also marking prostitutes, not with that same symbol, but the prostitutes weren't really marked in a bad way. It was more of a way to protect you from getting sexually transmitted diseases. So instead of like pills or medicine now, they use tattoos to represent, to ward off evil spirits. The Greeks call their tattoos a stigma, and they marked to represent the same as slaves, criminals, religious views. And then modern times, people do things for completely crazy reasons. You can get drunk and go get a tattoo. You can plan out your whole life to get a tattoo. You can be a part of a group, like a motorcycle group, and get a tattoo. There's all these different reasons why you would get a tattoo. Most people get tattoos to remind them of the deceased, their beliefs, their heritage, their culture, where they came from, who they are. A good, but most modern person I can think of is Johnny Depp, has 13 tattoos. He has Winona written right here for when he was in a relationship with her. He has his son tattooed, I think, right here, Jack Sparrow from the movie. His son's name's Jack. He has one for his daughter, I believe, on this arm. So he's just kind of like the more resembling, but there's also people like Justin Bieber, I know, has a bunch of tattoos. But there's this museum that they're starting up in the spring of 2014, which I think is pretty cool. It's called Tattoo, and it's all about the history of tattoos, where they came from, the meaning, how they originated. So it's pretty much saying what I said, but in more depth, with more evidence. And the curator, Anna Friedman, everybody who works here has a PhD in history, facts, and they all spend their whole entire time searching for like clues on what tattoos mean. And she said, tattoos signal who we are, what we believe, and our self-identity. Tattooing crosses cultural and generational lines, but is important to our universal visual culture, which is kind of uplifting in a way, because we each have different tattoos for different reasons, but as a universe, it's like creating us more, it's adding more to our, the people, the type of people we are becoming. So pretty much tattoos can change, and there's just like anything in the culture, things come and go, fads come and go, the types of tattoos come and go. What we get now when we're young, when we're older, might not be necessarily popular, but tattoos are going to be relevant no matter what, and I think that they're going to continue to be relevant. I don't think that they're ever going to go out of style, because if you look, people have had tattoos, you know, like my parents, my grandparents had tattoos. They might not have been proud of their tattoos later on in life, but they still had them, and so I think that they're going to continue, and you do have technology to erase them, but a lot of that costs so much or has so much negatives that it's not really going to eliminate them completely. But the Smithsonian is where I got most of my information in archaeology.com. They were really in depth with the information. But yeah, thank you. Okay, how long was that?